as things have gotten worse, I continue to be optimistic that the scale of the tragedy is going to be directly proportional to the scale of the change that we can cause. And there are so many areas where it's being highlighted right now that we need change, we need positive growth. In areas like healthcare and education, in employment law, I mean, all of these areas where progressive policies could really benefit everybody from the working class all the way up to, corporate presidents. Everybody benefits when we all rise together. And so I'm extremely hopeful that the influence of this time, what we're going through right now, is going to leave an indelible mark on the psyche of the whole country, and on our state in particular, right? And the young people who are coming up through this, it's going to shape their worldview. And I would hope shape their worldview in a way that they bring forth a will of society that points to a more positive, progressive direction that's equitable for everybody, that's good for all of us, that has people treated fairly in society and by the law. I mean, we're going to have great opportunities for criminal justice reform, for healthcare reform, and we just have to go after it. And there ain't no power like the power of the people, and the power of the people don't stop. And that's how I got elected, with a large volunteer effort. And we have got great enthusiasm and great momentum in a number of races, but it still is vitally important that we draw fair districts. And if the Democrats have the majority in the Texas House, we have the Speaker's chair, and we will chair the redistricting committee. We get to draw the maps. And while Republicans control the other levers of power, if the Democrats have the House, we have a real position for fighting for fair maps, and it's going to be a huge focus of the session. And I think we have a very good chance to do it. It's going to be a lot of hard work, but we've got a bunch of competitive House races that I feel very good about Democrats taking the majority in the House and electing a Democratic Speaker of the Texas House.